Welcome to another short Great Car Basic video, and this is about setting up your programmer. It's November 2015, so we're just about to release a new release, and I thought it was worthwhile covering this off as we've had a couple of requests about it. Okay, so what have I got? I've got a PIC kit 2, it's laying on my desk here. I've got a chip attached to a demo board, and I've got some LEDs at the end, okay? Let me start Great Car Basic, okay? And I'll show you what we're going to do. So in Great Car Basic, I've just installed Great Car Basic. I've got all my files, and you should read them all. That's the released, that's the history, the readme file, and then I've got these two files called FlashPIC and FlashAVR, but I'm going to actually get rid of those for the time, but we're going to return back to those. Okay, so I'm going to take a demonstration, and I'm going to compile it up. I'm going to make those LEDs flash, so I'll open up the LED solutions, simple on and off, and I'll take the 16F690, which is this piece of code here, which is a demonstration piece of code. So if I flash that and put a hex on it, try to hex it, it doesn't actually program it because the batch file that supports the programmer has not been configured. So how do we do that? Tools, external tools, edit the PIC programmer. And in here, it shows you how to use many different programmers. I won't go into all of them today. I'm going to show you the PIC kit 2 as the example. You've got a PGM, PIC kit 3, or the bootloaders, etc. But I'm just going to remove the remark statement, or REM, from this command line, and this will actually program it using a PIC kit 2, and it will leave the power on. Okay, so if you don't want that, there are other options that are documented in here, and I'm going to save it. So now, if I move my screen about, when I press hex and flash the button, it will hex it, it will assemble it, compile it, and do its funky stuff. And then it will sit there. Then it will then program it. We can see the busy lights come on, and it's probably programmed it. How do we know that? Well, we can see that my program in here is flashing away. So I'll just change some parameters in here. We'll just convince ourselves that that's working. So I'm going to press hex and flash. Just move that across a little bit. So all I've done is opened up the batch file, uncommented the REM statement, and now it's programming from the IDE. So to recap, how do I do this? Tools, external tools, edit PIC, and if you've got an AVR, it's the same process. Edit the AVR file, read that file in there, and that's how you change the programming setups. So, it was a very short video setting up your programmer. I'll call that a wrap.